to the Oracle.
Tiana, it's you. You're the Glacian.
Tales of the past and hopes for the future are manifest in the King of Kings. The Frostbearer's blessing shall be his. The Six have safeguarded this star since time immemorial. Each of a different mind, but united by this common purpose. The gods' protection extends to all creatures here below, even to the mortals created in their image. They are feeble creatures leading fragile lives and clinging to foolish fancies. The Frostbearer scorns these visions of hope, which melt like snow in the sun's light. Yet the Pyreburner admires their strength of will. For their reverence, he grants unto them his flame, and the world of man flourishes. His benevolence warms the frozen heart of the Frostbearer. The mortals have earned her respect, he her love and admiration. It is not long, however, before some among those men ascend to new heights of hubris. The people of Solheim spurn the gods who bless them, the gods they once worshipped. The ungrateful mortals incur the wrath of the Pyreburner. He seeks to raise the very civilization his flames once helped build. But the Six are sworn to defend the star and all her inhabitants from harm, and, at times, from one another. The flames of war surge as Solheim fends off the Pyreburner's fire. The gods' pleas for peace fall on deaf ears, and the battle rages on. When the smoke clears, the world of man is in ruins, their star left scarred for time eternal. Wearied from war, the Six seek solace in slumber. This tale of our shared past is entrusted to the King of Kings, that he may see it to its conclusion. In the days that follow the war, while the Six are still asleep, the Pyreburner is sought by a man who draws him away from the light. His peril is sensed by the Frostbearer. She rushes to his aid, only to be felled by the foreign hordes. Those masses are now one with the darkness. Darkness that before long will swallow the Six and the star they protect. This star's fate no longer rests in the hands of the gods. It sits on the shoulders of the Chosen. Deliver this world from darkness and grant my love release.
I promise I will.
The Oracle is no longer of this world, but her thoughts remain, and they must be known. Begins his existence on this star, the girl is met by the High Messenger. It is ordained that she will work with him to return the light. The girl reaffirms that promise. The High Messenger is moved by the girl's determination, her heart warmed by the girl's benevolence. Her faith in mankind is restored once more.
Sister, cease this madness. That boy will never be king.
Noctis is chosen. It is ordained. You of all people should know.
I know that you are throwing your life away.
That may be. But it's my choice. If only... If only I could hear his voice once more. If we could laugh together as we did as children. we could live out our days together as we once dreamed.
Wherefore does the lady weep?
Forgive me. I vowed to only cry where prying eyes cannot see the tears in mine.
Yet others need that hide their grief. Is she so different from them?
No. She is no different at all. She wants exactly what they do. To be with the one she loves. But want though she may, it is not to be.
The lady's thoughts have been hurt. The love she bears the king shall never fade. And, in time, her feelings shall be known unto him.
Gentiana.
And if the words are not spoken from her lips, then the messenger shall see that they are heard. The god's favor and the lady's love shall be with him evermore. Thus it is promised between the oracle and her familiar.
I am undeserving of your kindness.
So the promise is fulfilled. As her words go with him, so shall my blessing.
Yeah. Thanks.
O King of Kings, restore the light unto this world.
Farewell, dear Noctis.
Luna, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I couldn't be there for you. Not even when you needed me most. There was so much you wanted to say. So much I wanted to say. And now,
I won't let you down.
I know you won't.